кетчуп, но... Здесь макароны, do not need. О, бабушка! Welcome to Poland, курва мач!
Yes, Boris!
Welcome everyone to Professional Slavic Country Review through the eyes of Boris the Chachi King. Okay, let's get right into it. Poland is very nice country, with great many things to offer, including some of the best mayonnaise ever created. So why did I go to Poland in first place? Because you know, fuck it, why not, I just felt like driving. Sedan, startup Blatmobile, drive 1000 kilometers and opa is Poland. So what are things to see in Poland? Well, the beer price tags are very nice to look at. And of course, let's not forget top quality Slav fashion sense. Although taking pictures of Adidas shop, you will get kicked out of shopping center until you get to next shopping center and you try to explain, no, блядь, I am Slav superstar, why you do this? And then go for drink instead. But no, before you even arrive in capital city of Poland, you go through fucking hours of roadworks and big trucks. There's a million of these trucks everywhere, and my guess is they are carrying good quality Polish mayonnaise to rest of world. But now even before you arrive in Poland, there is guarded border checkpoint coming to ask you about something наш папироса. And at this point I did realize you really need to speak Polish to go to Poland. Because after asking him English, he said no. And after saying по-русски, he clearly lost his interest to talk to me any longer and hinted me to kindly fuck off. So I did and got a beer, it was good. Once I finally arrived in capital city of Warsaw, I was instantly greeted with many places willing to sell me a lot of beer at very good price. Most of these places being open 24 hours every day, but this being Slav country, I am not surprised. Looking back at our Polish lesson, what do we remember? Beer is pivo, yes, correct. You go to shop, you say jedno pivo, proszę. And not usual pivo, сука, блять. Or if you are in hurry, you can say jedno pivo, kurva mach. They will understand. So when I went to Warsaw, I was expecting high-rise Soviet-style apartment buildings. But what I got instead was these massive office buildings and hotels. And high-rise buildings, of course. And блин, was there so many trams here. There was maybe 5-6 buses and a trillion trams, блин. More trams than cherries in бабушка's компот. Блин, there is even bar named трамвай. And what is up with all the kebab places? Does everyone like kebabs too much? Блин, seriously, I'm considering coming to Poland and start my own business. The Palace of the Shashlik King. We serve blins, shashlik and компот. You show up in Adidas tracksuit, you get 10% discount. So what else is there you can buy? Clothes with price of kilogram. City is very nice and green. There is bench for sleep if you have had too much vodka. And some rare black chickens here. Some more high-rise apartment buildings right in town center. Right next to fancy hotel that cost you arm and leg to stay in. And maybe half of liver. But at least there is flower shop for you to buy. Because remember, Slav girls, they love their flowers. And the fancy cars, oh my god, look at this shit, блять. I should have gotten this for, блять, mobile. Look at that quality. And another pretty common thing to see is this. And I do not mean street market selling components for компот. But they actually sell whole sunflowers here. Now that is next level of Slav. If you are walking on street and you happen to not be in shopping center, you will see that every shop is as small as neighbor Vadim's apartment. And there is 100 shops on each big road where you can buy everything you fulfill your Slav needs. Including, but not limited to, even more alcohol. Looking at traffic in midtown Warsaw, you might consider it is very calm and normal, but you actually have to drive like race driver to keep pace with everyone else. My suggestion, you come try it out yourself. The metro tunnels in town look something directly taken from the brain of the author of Metro 2033, but sadly inside I did not find any trace of mutants or Artyom. And since the air was breathable outside, I just went for drink instead. If you want to travel to Poland, you will need to know they have their own currency, the Polish zloty. After I exchanged some currency and went to Poland and checked out the prices, I realized something. I fucking love Poland! And then went for drink. There are many smaller cities in Poland you can check out, like this Lomża, for example. Very nice people here. Actually, there is very nice people all around Poland, especially if you know how to speak Polish You see, Jen Dobry is all okay. People are very happy to help you find good squad location and also take picture. Also remember, if you want to fit into local crowd, just put on your track suit. Look at this guy, Adidas pants and Nike shoes. I bet you 5 blins he watches my channel, so go ahead and watch it as well. Put on your track suit and let's turn this cheeky set into a cheeky breaky. If you like walking streets of Warsaw, you will see many nice things to take pictures of. Like this beautiful wall of art, for example, being accompanied by its official guardian, the squatting gopnik. Okay, so other times you will just see some crazy shit. Most of the time, shit that you do not want explanation to. Or maybe other times you might come across one of these cars that has seen some rough slav love, both outside and in. Okay, maybe I should not be complaining, maybe this is some unregular car. If you plan to go on exploring some of the back streets of Warsaw, keep in mind that you are usually not alone, and you could find some new friends of Cheeky Breaky Hard Bus. And then, go for a drink. You know, generally, for most people, there is no reason to go to Poland, ever. But for old lady, I can say 3 reasons. 1. Good mayonnaise. 2. The beer is cheap and good. And 3. They have shop named Kakadu, блин. It is like they knew I was coming. I'm honored, Poland, you make me happy. This is some Slav magic. Some more reasons I like Poland so much, especially since I was driving. There is a million signs on highway saying конец. As if to say, the end is near, don't worry, you'll be hitting a deer. And also driving along highway, I see these signs. Danger, pieси. So I try remember. Hello, Jen Dobry, to vizhenie is goodbye. Сука, yes, yes. Aha, dog, pies! So all the time I'm driving, I'm thinking, do they have problem with wild dogs here or what? But after driving home very carefully looking for dogs, it turned out pieси does not mean dogs after all, it means pedestrians. So that's why I almost ran people over. Блин. And my last favorite sign, no, not that. I mean sign of cows on road, giving milk to fuel the Polish economy. Well, of course it doesn't say that on sign, but it is strongly implied. If you do plan to go exploring in city center of Warsaw, I strongly suggest you do it at day. It's not that people are going to mug you or steal your money. It's just that in daytime you are more likely to hear someone scream KURVA MACH! And that will make the trip worth it. If it is someone missing their tram, or maybe someone falling off their rental bike, there is always reason to say KURVA. Like for example, PADA DESCH KURVA, which means it's fucking raining. In city center there is large clock tower, it shows the time. Oh look, it's beer o'clock! Some very helpful people here to teach you some mathematics, like блин plus блин equals блять. If you're into some modern Polish art, then I suggest you check out the shopping cart of fortune. Some say the bum who rolled this here is now Polish Olympic athlete. Others say this cart has been here from beginning of time. I say it is beautiful, блять. It is beautiful. But if you really want to see something truly beautiful, just open your eyes, man. And get out of the way, because locals drive twice as fast as speed limit. So there is 1000 places in Poland you can visit. If I could, I would squat on every street corner of every town of every city and visit every Adidas shop, just to say, never fear, Boris is here. But remember, if you do happen to go outside in the night, try out the local pubs and food places, you will like it. Warsaw at night is beautiful. And never fear to go on the Polonaise taxi. It will take you in new Slav directions you have never seen before. But probably to shop to get some more pivo and vodka. And after you drive the long way back to your home, remember the Polish kielbasa you bought. Dip it inside the sweet heavenly Slav elixir. That is Polish mayonnaise. Don't forget to lock your door unless you want other people to get the wrong idea. I mean, Polish sausage is not for sharing, блять. You think I drive to Poland for fun? No, no, no. Friends suggest me I try this mayonnaise vineyard. And now, when I run out, I need to go back to Poland, блять. That is the way of the Slav and the Boris. You want it, you go get it. And that is exactly how I will be doing next Slav country review. If you like this video, write in comments what country I should visit next. But until then, my friends, I will be enjoying my kielbasa and mayonnaise from Poland. Stay cheeky breaky, my friends. I will see you next time.